أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح.
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
حي على الفلاح.
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهديه الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاد حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلاةً وسلامًا على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وهم يصطرخون فيها ربنا أخرجنا نعمل صالحا غير الذي كنا نعمل أولم نعمركم ما يتذكر فيه من تذكر وجاءكم النذير. وعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: أعمار أمتي ما بين 60 و70 وأقلهم من يجاوز ذلك، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد، all praise to Allah. All praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that He is the creator of this universe, and He is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is His messenger. True mercy sent to us. If you follow His path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. Amma ba'd. Alhamdulillah, today, with the praise of Allah, we're back again shoulder to shoulder. Wallahi, when the Imam in Mahram in Makki said shoulder to shoulder, everyone was crying there. It's beautiful to come back again to one line. And inshallah soon everyone will be norm again and go back to the normal place. But anyway, the khutbah today about how to use our time wisely and nicely. Subhanallah, I'll tell you something. We live for 100 years. Assuming, let's take 100 years to make it easy on us. 100 years computation, okay? How many hours we sleep a day? 8 hours. Everyone, 8 hours. Then one third of your life, we are sleeping. Then how many years? 30 years. I know it's 33. I'm a math. It's okay. Make it 30 to make it simple. 30 years. And subhanAllah, we eat and drink and walk and talk and work 8 hours. Another 8 hours. Another 30 years. Okay? And then we have fun, we play, we enjoy, we watch TV, we chat and do whatever and whenever. Another 6 hours a day, 5 hours a day. It's almost, we're talking about another 30 is gone. The remaining of 100. A remaining of 100 is almost 10 years. Then someone lived for 100 years He's accountable for the 100 years and really you live 10 years. Go ahead, compute it yourself. It's up to you. Inshallah, I have here one by one. What's your life doing? Subhanallah, it's when I prepared it's anyway, alhamdulillah, subhanallah. Then what should we do in these 10 years of our lives? How can we use the time wisely? Because even if you prayed this whole 10 years, it's counted as 10 years. How about the rest of 100? What will happen? The whole last 90 years? How can we get hasanat for the whole 90? We're accountable. What are you gonna do? And subhanAllah, with the praise of Allah, Allah gave us the way to get more than the 90 with simple acts. Let's see. Last one. The first act is we pray Fajr. Try to pray Fajr in Jama'ah. Someone, you know, I'm lazy. I cannot go to, you know, to the places here, the mosques. It's far away from me. Okay, no problem. Wake with your wife, with your family, with your kids. Make Jama'ah at home. It's better to go in the mosque. Make Jama'ah at home. Try your best. Try your best. This is the way I can do it. Oh Allah, this is the maximum I can go. Do it. Make Jama'ah at home. Then, if you do the Jama'ah at home, try to wake up for 1 hour more. This will take from your sleep time 1 hour. 1 hour more per day. What is this equal to? If you stay in your place until sun rises, it is equal to Hajj and Umrah. A reward, simple reward. You stay for an hour, it's equal to Hajj and Umrah. Stay just reading the Quran. And someone will say, how can you get this? Where is this in the hadith? The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, من صلى الفجر في جماعة ثم جلس يذكر الله حتى تطلع الشمس ثم صلى ركعتين كتب له أجر حجة وعمرة تامة تامة. وفي رواية عند الطبري وصلى وسبح حتى الضحى. Then really what does it mean? You sit, praise Allah, read the Quran, read your word, one juz a day, try. By the way, the one juz part, it was hard on me. I'm telling you the truth, it was hard. It's hard on all of us. What should you do? Try to read at least one page. Open the Mus'haf, one page, close, go. And after a while, it will increase. After a while, piece by piece, don't, oh, I cannot, I don't have time, no problem. Open the Mus'haf, read one line and close, then go. One line, you cannot go one line. ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Done. Close. Go. To wherever you go and go. And wallahi you will see the barakah that you will increase one by one, piece by piece, until you get it the whole juz every day and more even sometimes. Then I told you to pray الضحى 2 ركعة and some of the ulama said 4. Look at this hadith. يصبح على كل سلامة من أحدكم صدقة. فكل تسبيحة صدقة وكل تحميدة صدقة وكل تهليلة صدقة وكل تكبيرة صدقة وأمر بالمعروف صدقة ونهي عن المنكر صدقة. Look at how much we're gonna do. You say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. You try to make amr ma'roof. You try to help, to support, to said all of that. How much effort we'll do that? Lot, right? A lot of effort. ويجزي عن ذلك كله. The remaining part of the hadith. ركعتين يجوز أن ركعتين يركعهما في الضحى. 2 ركعة of ضحى. 2 ركعة. Just 2 ركعة will give you the reward of all of what I said before. Then really, don't want to take it? 2 ركعة. When you wake up, I said it's better to wake up from after Fajr, stay for an hour. It's better. But if you want to sleep, when you wake up, do 2 ركعة ضحى after Fajr prayer. Then, look at this. After the every prayer, that's why we ask the youth, especially under 25. I'm under 25, subhanAllah. I wish I was under 25. Under 25, that and over 25. That to read Ayat al-Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa hu. What's the reward? If you just read Allah, how long does it take Allahu la ilaha hu? 10 seconds? 15 seconds? If you're too good, Sheikh Abdulaziz is reading it, 1 minute? With the ahkam and everything. What's the reward? ريورد في آية الكرسي، من قرأ آية الكرسي عقب كل صلاة مكتوبة لم يمنعه من دخول الجنة إلى الموت. You're guaranteed جنة. And someone will say, how can this happen? How can I guarantee جنة? Because you're remembering Allah after each prayer. Connect to Allah after each prayer. This is how it works. Connection, the idea of itself is connect. You have it in your mind that there is Allah. I'll take care of him. I'll work with him. I'll make sure that he's happy with me. This is how it works. Subhanallah. Then, what else? After each prayer, after you read Ayatul Kursi, you say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. 33 times. And you finish with La ilaha illallah. And always the ulama said, use your fingers, it's better. But anyway, you can use Sibha, it's up to you. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Or Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. And 33 times. We have Subhanallah 30 once, and one finger is 33. You have 33 times, you say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. What is the reward? I like all those rewards. Like when you play Fortnite, you need rewards, you need coins, you need to win, right? What's the winning here of this? The winning. The winning is your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. Just saying that. How long does it take? I'm telling you minutes. I'm telling you minutes of your day. Of your 10 years, if you're just coming in, you're living your life 100 years, you have time only to worship 10 years only of your life. I'm telling you so many things, that so many techniques that you can get more hasanat with short time. Look at this. A hadith. That's why I said, من يقول لا إله إلا الله والله يقول لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله إلا كفرت عنه ذنوبه ولو كانت مثل زبد البحر. Your sins are forgiven even it's equal to the foam of the sea. Just saying سبحان الله after each prayer, سبحان الله الحمد لله الله أكبر 33 times after each prayer. How hard is this? The Prophet loves us all, wallahi. When you hear that, when I heard that, the Prophet loves us in a way that he wants us all to be in Jannah. Well, that's why the hadith, if you remember, even though it's not written here, كل أمتي يدخون الجنة إلا من أبا. Every one of our ummah, of the Prophet's ummah, will go to Jannah, except if you don't want to. And the Sahaba asked the question I want to ask. Who will reject Jannah? Who has the mental think that he will reject Jannah? Why should I reject Jannah? I'm going to Jannah. No. The Prophet said, من أطاعني كل أمتي معافى إلا من أبى قال ومن يأبى رسوله قال من أطاعني دخل جنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. Everyone will follow my footsteps, will go to Jannah. ومن عصاني, if you reject his commands. And the Prophet, by the way, look at this. He's so merciful. Wallahi, when you read the hadith, he's so merciful. He didn't say he would go to the hellfire. No. He said, وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ أَبَى. He didn't say he will go to hellfire. Why? Because you want us all to feel the Jannah part. To feel the Jannah. You want to go to Jannah. You want to be there. That's how it works. Subhanallah. And subhanallah, what else can we do? What else? The hadith said, after the shahud, innaka hamidun majid, always make a dua. Remember that part. Make a dua, any dua. Usually I tell everyone around us when we do, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Allahumma aghfir lana, Allahumma arhamna, Allahumma hadina. After he says salamu alaykum, you start making dua. No! You still have time, you have a leeway, you have some time there. After innaka hamidun majid, make dua. Say something to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're still in Allah. You have a hot connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stay with him. Stay connected so that Allah will hear you. It's better than making dua. Definitely make dua anytime is good. But in prayer is much better. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لكم فاستغفروا يا فوز المستغفرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وتوفنا وصالحنا. اللهم اغفر لنا إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وعي سيئات عمل. أما بعد, there is a hadith after you say إنك حميد مجيد, the Prophet taught us about Try to remember it. Try to memorize it as much as you can. What is the four things that we are scared of? Everyone. When you die. فتنة المحيا that getting deviated in our lifetime. وفتنة الممات. When you die, Satan comes to us. Everyone, by the way. Everyone, Satan will come to you and say, try to deviate you out. Try to take you out of Islam. He will try his best to do that. فتنة المحيا وفتنة الممات وفتنة وعذاب القبر وعذاب النار. Four things. Four things we are scared of. Then before you do salam, what you should say? اللهم قنا من فتنة المحيا وفتنة الممات اللهم إن أعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا وفتنة الممات وعذاب القبر وعذاب النار. Four things. Four things you say after each prayer. What will happen? The hellfire will make dua to you not to get in. The hellfire itself will make dua to every one of us. Just saying that. Saying this part. What else? I'm trying to give you some techniques that these 10 years of your life will be accountable to hundreds and hundreds of years. Subhanallah. And by the way, I didn't talk about Laylatul Qadr. I didn't talk about 2 raka'ah at night. I didn't talk about so many other things. I'm saying the techniques that we can do it while we're walking, while leaving the mosque. Sometimes I stand there and say, remember, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, 30 times the sunnah of the Prophet. And really, it will forgive all the sins. Subhanallah. Sami'a Rasulullah s.a.w. Sami'a an-Nabi, qala inna, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi'anni ashhadu annaka bi'ashhadu annaka anta Allahu la ilaha illa ant. Al-ahadu as-samad, alladhi lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Faqal, one of the sahaba made this dua. اللهم أنت الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Okay, this dua, he said it in the tahiyyat again before he leaves. That's why always remember this. Maybe 10-15 seconds before you do taslim, try to make as much dua as possible. And by the way, some of the people said I have to stand beside this adiyah. No, you can create your own dua. Because it's free dua, it's up to you. Oh Allah, give me money. Oh Allah, give me wealth, health. Oh Allah, make me win in Fortnite. You can say that. You can make any dua you want. Really, but do it in prayer, not outside. Look at this. If you say Subhanallah, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم Subhanallah وبحمده 100 times. If you say Subhanallah وبحمده 100 times, your sins will be forgiven. Definitely, like I said, oh, I have a long list here. Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr is equal to 83 years. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a khutbah before. Allah didn't say it's equal. إِنَّ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ تساوي. Allah didn't say تساوي. خير. خير means if you have a million and I have a million and one. I'm have more than you. Right? Or you have million and one. You have more than me. How about if you have a billion? Still you have more than me. Trillion. You have more than me. Allah said khair. Khair means more. I don't know how far more. But Allah wants to make us the longest one who lived in this life. 83 years. How long? This is our lives? Subhanallah. Yawm Arafah forgives two years of hasanat. Yawm Ashura forgives 1 year. Ramadan, definitely. Ramadan. And between the sujood. I gave a khutbah before about it. Between the sujood, you say what? Allahumma aghfir li. Oh Allah, you know, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la. And you sit. I hear so many people sit, hoping that the imam will go to the second sujood. No. When you sit, you say, what? Allahumma aghfir li. Oh Allah, forgive me. Forgive my parents and forgive the Muslimin. All forgive whoever I owe him something. Why? The ulama said, the most one you want to ask Allah forgiveness is me, right? Me, I'm the first one. And definitely the second one after me is my parents, because they deserve that. And then the Muslimin, imagine that I told before that we are now almost going to 2 billion. Imagine that 1 billion are praying like us and they're saying the same dua. They're passing to you almost 1 billion hasana for each sujood, between two sujood. Because I'm giving dua to everyone. اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي والمسلمين. Remember that part. You are in the mode of giving. Try that part. دفنت لي الصلاة على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عليه الصلاة والسلام. Why؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى سيدنا القرآن من صلى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما عليه الصلاة والسلام. Then the Prophet said, if you praise the Prophet once, Allah will praise you how many times? 10 times. And the ulama said, once is enough. If Allah remembered they said your name once, you pass. You pass. Subhanallah. Then, remember that part. Remember, before I end, subhanallah, time flies on me. Remember to use your time wisely. Remember when you're sitting in the car, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Remember to say salam, smile. Wallahi, even under the mask, smile. The smile is a charity by itself, sadaqa. Tabassumuka fi wajhi akhika sadaqa. Sadaqa, you give charity. Alhamdulillah, I don't have money. I cannot give. But smile. It's hard to smile even. Smile. Two muscles to smile. Ask a doctor. Two muscles to smile. This is equal to charity in the sake of Allah. It's very important to do that. Remember two things, inshallah. Our brother, remember to boycott the French. Again, I'm always, still the French, this Macron, somehow we have to stop him. And still he's chit-chatting a lot about us. Hopefully we'll get him out soon, inshallah, in the next election. But anyway, make dua against him, inshallah. May Allah take him out. And definitely, now the Indian government, again, they are doing bad things to our brothers. They're killing them. Remember to talk to our MPs and MPPs. Try your best to make sure that they deliver, that we don't like that part. And inshallah, after the prayer, we'll make Salatul Ghaib ala our brother Radwan. He died yesterday, and they are praying on him, inshallah. And we'll pray on him, inshallah, after this, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وتوفنا صالحين اللهم اجمعنا ولا تفرقنا اللهم اجمعنا ولا تفرقنا وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سلم كثيرا وقوموا إلى صلاتكم ارحمكم الله. Before we make the adhan, inshallah, if you are vaccinated, move forward shoulder to shoulder. If you are not or you don't feel comfortable, stay the back. And by next week we'll start scanning everyone, inshallah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله